And so this is going to be fitting an amp into a F30, the British spec that's got the bass stereo. So in these there's no amplifier in the boot. In the American versions and overseas and that, there's often an amp down in the passenger side of the boot. However, the bass spec in the UK doesn't have that. So here I've got all my stuff that I should need. This amplifier is a juice something from Car Audio Center, and there's two high to low level converters. I did buy a Kenwood amp that took speaker level input, however they weren't in stock, so they sent that with those adapters, and a ISO extension cable saved me wiring cutting the cable behind the head unit. Speaker crimp terminals for the back, an inline fuse, 50 meters of 1.5 millimeter squared cable, some loom tape, battery terminal, and then some male and female bullet crimps and some heat shrink. I do need some riv nuts because I want to install it on the roof of the boot. And I've got my power cable. Ideally it would have been red. However, this was cheap, and it's, I want to say 8 gauge, I can't really remember. You'll need an assortment of Torx, screwdrivers. So the plan is to pull the dash apart, wire the speakers in behind the unit, take it through the passenger side, behind the glove box, and under, through the rear into the boot. Quite a few ways you can wire this, because obviously it's four channel coming out the head unit, one going to the driver's seat and door, passenger seat and door, and then one going to the rear driver's door and the rear passenger door. So the few ways I've seen you can do it is apparently you can code the head unit to output low level output straight to your amplifier in the boot. But I don't mess with that. You can also get a four channel amp and do just the fronts, but then you're not amplifying the rears. You can buy a six channel amp and amplify all four, six speakers separately, so you're splitting the subwoofer in the seat and the one in the mid in the door separate channels. However, I don't really want to be cutting the factory wiring harness like that. I know there's a connector down there under the seat, under the carpet, that goes to the subwoofer and then into the door, but that's only one channel. You can splice into that and make that two separate channels, but I'm just for simplicity using the stock loom from the head unit to the speakers, one channel for the front passengers, and then a separate channel, another channel on the front rear driver, and then another channel on the rear passenger. So four channels. The front two channels powering the one in the door and the subwoofer for each side, and then the rear channel just powering the one in the door. So battery's now disconnected, negative comes off first and positive. Word of advice for people with BMs or anyone, any car that's got a battery in the boot, tie a rag through your lock, because if you close your boot and your battery's disconnected, unless you've got folding seats, you're going to have a very miserable afternoon. Front passenger seat's out now. The way you do this is you slide the seat all the way back and undo the first two screws, they're T50s. Slide the chair forward, and again, two more T50s at the back. Excuse the dirt. So you then tilt the chair back, and here there's a plastic connector. You push the tab in and the black like thing over it, like that, and it should come out. That seat is now ready to be lifted out. We've got the seat belt, you've got to pull the trim that sits around there, T50 on that bolt, and then pull the seat belt up. That's the front seat out, so I want to get a clean with it before it goes back in. So yeah, you tilt it back and we carried it out the rear door rather than the front. You'd expect to take it out the front, but it's a bit easier out the back. So it's disconnected. Return your bolts to where you found them so they don't go missing. That's your seat belt connector. And obviously, like I say, put your bolts back and then you're not lost, are you? Pulled the carpet up in front of this rear front subwoofer, pulled this trim off here. A little trick with BMs is if you're wrenching the trim, That's not how it comes off. It shouldn't take a lot of force. It should just pull off. Everything should. It's quite straightforward. Now I'm going to try and clear the, so I can get under there, take so I can clear a cable run, pretty much take the glove box out and crack on. So under the footwell there's two 10mm bolts that go into that bracket there and that bracket up there. And then that trim there pops down. It's got a 12 volt socket in mine, so I just have to disconnect that cable which sits there. And now to try and get the glove box removed. Underneath the glove box here, there's four T20s as far as I can see. One up here, one up there, and as we go further back, holding the brackets up to the brackets, there's one there and one there. And then inside the glove box again, there's four T20s. All of them need to be removed to get the glove box out. Then eight bolts removed now, there's a trim panel here. Just pry it off with a screwdriver and pull the weather stripping off. Inside there, I think that's a T20, possibly a T25 on that. On there. And then remove that, the glove box should pull out, he says. Right, so that took some force, like some wriggling to get that out. On here there's a few connectors. Just make sure you take them out and put them in the right way. So like for argument's sake, the light on the top, the brown cable goes towards the back. There's one cable down there, but I can't see that. Remove them and we're getting there. Now this cable here is going to the thing that the resistance on the door, the cable that goes to the back of that. I take it rather to tell whether the glove box is closed or not. I'm not sure whether the polarity of it matters, but the brown wire with the black stripe in it goes closest to the left hand side of the tube. You just put them in the same way you got them out. It doesn't look like there's an orient, like it does look like you can put it the wrong way. I'm not too sure. Job now is to pull this trim piece off, which will expose the bolt, the T20 bolts for the head unit fascia. While you're down here, there's a fascia under here that pulls down from the top and out, exposing the other two T20 nuts or bolts for the fascia. This trim piece off, that just pulls off, and then inside here you've got two connectors, one for the control, climate control, and the other for the two buttons. They can only go in one way, and then can only come out one way, and then that's that trim piece out. This is out now. All that's left to do to get the head unit fascia off is there's four T20 bolts and then a little connector down behind the right hand side. Pull that out and then you're looking at your DVD, your CD player. This is out. I've just taken the two T20 bolts that are out there. I've left the connector on because it hangs out of the way. There's no need to take it off. Now this looks like this should just pull out, and yeah. And behind there is where the ISO adapter is going to go. So that's now all the cable. That's the what I'm planning. How I'm planning on routing it is the cable's going to come out the back there. It's going to come down under here, out the way, down here under this carpet. That tunnel there, follow the tunnel straight through the back, up here, through into the boot. Now I've got to try and clear a cable run to the back seat, which is going to include getting the back seats out. The rear seat base is out. There's just a clip there. The clip there, you pull up on it, pull the seat belt things through, and you're laughing. To get the rear piece off, there's two T50s under the centre. There and there under the center seat, and then you pull up quite forcefully on the like side bit by the doors, and then it should just lift off, and then you have to hook your seat belts out and lift it out. It should take you straight into the boot. So the rear seat and the base is out now, straight into the boot. So all that's holding it in is there's a clip which clips in down here onto that there, and then the same the other side. And then these two clips up here, so it's just a lift. It is a two-person carry to get them back off again. It isn't straightforward. And now I'm going to attempt, because I want to get my cables under the boot, so maybe possibly try and take the parcel shelf out to see if we can run the cables up and into the parcel shelf opposed to into these side pieces. And the plan is, instead of running the cables through the back, I'm going to run them up into the parcel shelf and drop them down one of the holes there. So this parcel shelf has took a bit of struggling to get off. So the way this comes off is you pull out all the little clips. There's four on here and one on the bit of trim that goes around the seat belt either side. So you have to remove them. So then you've got your C pillars. They pull off from the glass and from the center. There's a clip there and a clip there. Same with the other side. And then a T20 bolt at the back of the thing, and then you're free to lift this up and over like that. Easy. Get in there. So this trim panel comes off. It's held on by this little plastic riveting nut thing. You pull the shaft out, and then you use something like that to then pull the base piece out. This again comes out. You just pull the weather stripping off either side, pull the clips out from the bottom, and then the whole panel drops. So now all that's left to do for the speaker cables is loosen this bit of carpet off down here. So then we'll have a straight cable run from the back of the stereo, down the side of the trim, through the back of the dash, down the side here, under the carpet here, up through the back, following these cables up here, going up, round, and down the back of the parcel shelf, and down into these holes, which will make it perfect to mount along the back, because I'm going to mount it upside down. And then the plan for the power cable is to follow a similar idea, is to run the power from the battery through this panel trim piece here, up the back, round, and drop it down, hopefully giving it a really tidy look. And then I've got to find a nice place to ground it to. We're getting there. Now, time to run some cable. This carpet just peels off. So what we're going to have to do is run 8 cables from the head unit to the back of the amplifier up on the parcel shelf, which is going to be up there. 4 are going to be going from the head unit to the amp for each corner of the car, and then 4 returning from the head unit, from the amp, sorry, back to the head unit. So we need 8 lengths of cable, and then 1 length of cable for the remote power to turn on when the stereo, when the head unit comes on. We're getting there. So I've got 1 length of cable cut. I measured it all up in there, put it where it needs to go, and I've took it out. I'm going to cut another 7 of those into about 4 or 5 meters. I haven't measured it. I'm going to say probably closer to 5 to be on the safe side. And you've got to run 8 of them plus a wire, so you're probably going to be talking around the 45 meters. Let's hope my 50 meter reel does the trick. So I've had enough cable. 50 metres has got me 9 lengths and about 3 metres spare. Obviously you need, like I said, 8 for the speaker and then 1 for the power. 50 metres is what you need. And I'm going to get that taped up into a loom and then get it fitted, and then hopefully start fitting the trim back so it doesn't look in such a state. Obviously the parcel shelf's going to hang, so I'm going to have to run the cables for the battery, which is obviously the plan after that. And then, we'll see what happens when we get there. When you come to label these up, when you come to build the loom up, which is what I'm doing now, I'm going to split one of these down the centre, so there's only 1 cable. That's going to be the 12 volt switched. Just make sure you label everything up both sides, otherwise you'll have a whale of a time with a multimeter at the end. Just a bit of masking tape with A or B or whatever on it. It's straightforward, it saves you a lot of aggro. And yeah, I'm not wearing gloves because I like to, it's just the cable's making my hands itch. I'm going to get all these nice, neat and tidy, and then use my loom tape or cloth tape, whatever you call it, just to tidy it up and then get it rooted in the car. Start maybe getting the front end trim back in, like around the dash, the dash and the glove box. Start getting all these trim pieces back in, the pillar here. Can't really touch the rear seat because I want to get the wiring done with for the battery up, because that's going to come from the battery, take that trim off, up, round, down the back and through the hole there. And then when that and the ground are wired up, as far as I can think, that will be it in terms of running cables. And then everything can sort of go back in, and then you can have a car that doesn't really look like a pigsty. And then obviously I just wire that from that end, and that's it.
I wondered, I just thought I am using the speaker cable for the 12 volt switched. It is quite thick cable, it's 1.5 millimeters squared, so it's good quality cable. It should carry the 12 volts, it only draws normally about half an amp, so it should be fine. I'm just going to keep an eye on it, make sure it's not getting too warm, and if it's fine, then I'll keep it. If not, I'll have to buy some thicker cable, but I think it'll be fine. It looks fine to me, I'm happy with it. So we've got the main loom made up now. It's quite long, it's nice and tidy. It takes longer than you think, that does. I could have wrapped the lot, I had enough tape for it, but just for function more than anything, just to keep everything tidy and neat. But yeah, I've just sort of maybe just put it every sort of that distance all the way along. It's whatever feels right. So now I've just got to put this in the car, and then start tidying up the trim and all that.
Right then, so the cable route is now in place-ish. It's going to need taping to the like current looms that are running down there to try and keep everything from rattling, but just so people can see. Right, I've got about a hand's width dangling there. It's going through the top hole here, running around the back, behind the seatbelt thing, down the side, down here, down here, down here, following these looms down. Running under the cable, under the carpet even. Under here, and it gets to this box. Can't really pull this board out without bending it, so it's run up behind. It's gone up behind that, around the top, and underneath, at the back, following the big thick chunk of cable that's running around there, up the side, behind this metal piece here, up, and then into here. Now I haven't put much slack here because I've got that extender cable which is in the boot, which is going to have to be wide here. I don't want tons and tons of slack. You can buy these pre-built looms, I think, on the internet. I think they're about £80-90, although don't quote me on that, I'm not too sure. But I've paid £20 for the cable, £15 for the ISO extension block thing. And then all the other bits and pieces I've got about, so it's not a hard cable to make. But yeah, you don't want too much slack here. I've got all my slack at that end. I can always shift it about. So my plan is, I was going to put the glove box in, but I'm going to leave that out because I might need to tidy this up a bit when I come to wire. So I'm going to tape this all into the what's down there currently. I'm not going to record that, there's no need to it. And then I'm going to put this trim piece in, that trim piece in, this trim piece in, these two trim pieces in, and then I'm going to call that, I'll put the seat in. So all that's left then to go in is the dashboard. I'll try that again. The glove box and the dash trim, the rear seat and the parcel shelf, but I need all that for when I'm wiring. Just trying to tidy up, it's getting a bit messy. When I got my car left in a mess overnight. Taped in all nice and tidy now.
Yeah, I don't want to be able to see any of it. I'm not one of them that's into like audio systems, but just want so it sounds a bit nicer. So yeah, anyway, going back to what I was going to say. So when you pull these trims off, sometimes you leave the clips in the door or wherever they are. It's simply just a case of pulling them out with a pair of pliers, slide them back into the original clip and then just push down. It is really, really straightforward. It's not hard at all. So the order that I'm going to put them back in is, this is going to go in first, this one, and then this piece of trim that runs up here, and then the bit that goes over the weather strip. So we go on this side, so the bit's going to go in there by the box, and then just the strip that goes over the top there. Get the seat back in, leave the glove box as it is because I'll have to pull these cables out when I come to crimp and things and solder. But yeah, good progress so far. So in terms of time scale so far, I don't know, it's about 5 o'clock now, so it's taken me 3.5 hours so far. I'd earmark a good day for this, maybe it's even like a weekend would be ideal. I'm not rushing, I'm just taking my time because in doing a tidy job, because it's going to be in the car for a while. The nice thing about doing it this way with the connection and connector thing and not just wiring it straight into the loom is when I come to sell this car, I can pull it straight out in a matter of a couple of hours because it will already be made, and put it into my next BM or next car, as long as it's not a limo. I don't have that length of cable, but it should be fairly universal for most cars, I'd have thought. You might just have to change the connector on the actual extension cable, but other than that, it's going to be fairly straightforward no matter what car you're putting this in. So I've got all my weather stripping back on nice, all my trim on, it's hidden the cable all nice and tidy, seats back in, and then the trim up this end is all done, and now it's going to be dismantling the trim in the boot. And the left wheel arch trimming the boot, I suppose, to try and deal with the route the power cables now. So the speaker power cables I'm happy with, and then I'm going to run the battery cables in the same fashion. So I'm going to run it from the battery there, behind that panel, up, and then over the top and through into that hole there, or possibly the next one. And then I can get the back seat back in, and pass the shelf back in, the C-pillars, and then get the seat back in, and then sort of return to normal a bit then. I'm going to have a look at that over there, and then I'll do another video. Look on how you remove these here. It's fairly simple. Get a pry tool, and you pull that first post out. It leaves you with this little grommet thing, a side one-handed. And then you pull that out, and then that's off. Right, so I've removed this trim here. That's four clips there. And then I've removed this bottom piece here, which comes out with a clip there, which did not want to give up. So now this piece needs to come out here, and I'm happy then. Rear trim now all loose. There's one clip here. There's a clip up there, a clip up there, and then that bolt that needs removing, and that is your lot for that. And then this pulls off the weather stripping like that, and then that clip up there comes round and off. In regards to the fuel cap release cable, that little bit pops off and you can pull it through the trim. Fairly straightforward. I've got the power cables are now cut, ground and live, for the route. I'm just going to tape them together. Again, labelled the one I'm going to use for ground. And obviously the one that's not labelled is live. It just saves a lot of aggro later on. Keep everything nice and labelled and it's all straightforward. Just going to tape them up now into just together so I know what's what. And then take them to the current wires that are running through, just to keep everything nice and tidy. And then everything can go back in, the seats, the boot trim. And that'll leave me with my cables here to wire, and my two power cables. And then it'll leave me in the front with my power cables, speaker cables at the front to wire into the head unit. And then the main cable runs are done. And it's just a case of crimping, soldering, and then messing about getting it all working. I've done the run for the cables, for the power cables. They go through a little hole up at the top, which I didn't even know was there until I took the trim off, which I was well impressed with. It saved me a load of wire. So it comes up there and it runs across the back and then clips into the same hole that the other cable does. So there's that. And now I'm just going to put everything back. I've just wanted to do the main cable runs. I've got an inline fuse I've got to fit down here. I've got that to fit, but I can do that later when all the trim's back. It's just I want it to start tidying up a bit. I've done all the wire runs, so I've done the majority of the trim work. So I'm pleased with progress. So that's the boot trim back in. I basically put it in the reverse order. So this panel went in, this panel went in, that panel went in. Careful of that clip there. Let me clean my lens. That clip behind there, because it's not quite in, I need to get that in. I'm going to try and stop saying but we shall see how that pans out.
So I've got to get this parcel shelf back in and the clip. There we go, I've already said it. And the clips for the seatbelt back in, then the seat pillars back in, and then the seat back in. Right, so I've got to get this back in now. So before I put the parcel shelf back in, the cable run, that's your power cable run. They're behind the ISOFIX connectors. And the speaker comes across it. They both go into the same hole there. That'll all get taped up nice and neat when it comes through the other side. But for now, I've just got to get this parcel shelf back on. So that's the parcel shelf all in. Seat pillars all in. So it's just a case of getting the rear back bench in. And then we're all good. Ready to crack on and do some wiring. Probably able to do some up the front. Try and tidy that up a little bit for today. We're getting there. After a bit of a wrestle, back seats are back in. So it's all minus the mess. Oh, you don't even know it's there, which is ideal. So all we've got left now, the cable, is coming out the front here, which I'm now gonna start crimping the ends up. And then I can start getting the dash back together. And then at this end here, that's all we've got. So we're getting there, boots all in, looking tidy, it's getting there. So now I'm gonna pull this apart, the tape, and relabel it further down, strip these, put some male bullet connectors on these, and then I'm gonna crimp them, and then I'll pack them full of solder, and then heat shrink them to get a nice, good connection. All the ends stripped on these cables up in the footwell. So my plan now is to connect them, I did this one-handed, with a male bullet clip, their bullet terminal. And then I'm gonna crimp it on and then put some solder in it to give a good connection, and then hopefully get some heat shrink on it. So that slid down like that onto the sheath. Get a bit of connection on there. Right. So now we're on like that there. And now all you've got to do is crimp it. Need to find the pliers. Stick on them. This is a difficult one-handed. Between my legs, let's try that. Like that, and you come in from here and just give it a good crush. Now that brings in focus, it's solid. So I'm gonna pack a little bit of solder in there. Pull that back, just put a solder in there, and then it's all going to get heat shrunk, so it's not, it shouldn't short circuit or anything. But yeah, that's it, nice and easy. So I've terminated all the ends. I'm going to go pack some solder in them now. You really don't need to, you just preference and buy them, then you make sure you know you've got a good connection. So I'll pop some solder in all of those, and I'll do a little video update before I start heat shrinking them up. So I'll just pack some solder and then I'll start heat shrinking. Right, so my heat shrink's all cut and they're all soldered on. It's a nightmare getting them soldered. It's getting cold out and my soldering iron was struggling to keep up. We're losing a bit of light now, so I'm gonna get this heat shrink all on, take another quick video, let the heat shrink all on, and then call it a night for the car. I'm gonna take the connector, the ISO connector, into the house tonight and put the crimps on, solder, and heat shrink ready for tomorrow. So then that should all just be plug and play, and then we can play about in the route tomorrow. There we go, all heat shrunk now. Nice and tidy for tomorrow. I'm leaving that as it is. I'm just going to get the battery back on it tonight and then lock it up. So it's quarter to nine now. I started at about 1:30. So there, that's how it, so now all the cable runs are done. So my plan for tonight, I'm going to get in the house and I'm going to use the adapter cable, which is back here. And I'm going to put the female bullet connectors on there, crimp and solder them, heat shrink them, so they're all ready to crack on for tomorrow. And then that's all that done. It just needs plugging and playing, plugging in, everything putting back in. And then that's all the front tidy. And then we're just in the back. I've got to fit an inline fuse down on the battery, on the battery terminal. I've got to wire a lot of these up to the reducing converter. Find some way of mounting the amp, but I'm mounting up there. I've got to get some rivnuts on order, but for now I'm just gonna just some sticky velcro just to hold it in place while I wire it all up. And yeah, we'll be done tomorrow.
1 to 8 are speakers, and then pin 13 is switched 12 volt ignition on the ignition for the amplifier. Strips, cut them a bit longer and doubled them over because the cable's thin. It's in a crimp, sold, and heat shrink them now. I'm gonna go put it in the cart. That's all cut now. I had to take the sheath off the crimp so I could get some solder in, and then obviously because I've crimped it, then I can't get them back in the connectors. All you gotta do is just heat the end up with a lighter and then push it back over. So just heat shrink them now and then get it fitted in the cart. So that's all done, that side and that side. What I've got to do now is make a little splitter for the 12 volt remote turn on, just so that I can, because obviously this still needs to be connected to turn the head unit on, and I need a bit going off to power the amp, so I'm just gonna do that now. This is a splitter I've done. I've just got some speaker cable, cut the end and strip both cables, tied them together, put a crimp on the ends, which will go into the wiring harness we made yesterday, and then these two bullet connectors will go onto the female one's there, just needs a bit of solder and heat shrink, and then get it all tidied up. There's it fitted there, and heat shrunk over the connections, all taped up. We're ready to go to the loom. So, my connections are all made now in the back. It's all going to get taped up when it's done. I just need one to test it first. So I've got the cables A, B, C, and D that I labelled. They're going to from the head unit to the amp. And then E, F, G, and H are coming back from the amp to carry on with the loom going to the speakers. So that's how I've labelled it, like that. So they're going to be A to D, going to be sent, and then E to H are receiving. And then you just know that, and then the colours here are the colours that correspond with the loom. So that is now ready to go into the head unit, which I'm going to do now. So this is all wired up. It's not going to be tidy yet. I want to test it all works before I tidy it up and tape it up and make it all nice. After this, we're going to go in the boot, try and get that tidied up in there and that wired, and then hopefully deal with the power, and then we're ready to test it. So I just had a right game on. So I've wired it all up in the footwell here and then tried to post the cable through. Well, there's not really any gap for the connector. So it took me ages. What I've had to do is bring you can only fit the male connector through the gap, not the female connector. So I had to pass the female connector through, the male connector from the car to the male connector that I've built. The male connector from the car to the female connector of the cable I've just built. And then I had to pass the male through to try and get the back of the head unit. So it's going to be some cables packed up here, which is not what I wanted, but without dismantling the dash, it's the best I'm going to get. It's going to have to be pulled out later to be taped though, but for now, we're in. So I've got the amp approximately where it needs to go. I haven't got any rivnuts or any bolts or anything to put it up with because I'm waiting on the post. So I've got it held up with an axle stand, a few cable ties to secure it in place, but it's not going anywhere. I'm not going to drive it like that. That's just so I can wire it in place. Now I'm going to try and make sense of these cables. And get the converters stuck up. I might stick them on the back here. I'm not sure yet. Not sure where I want to stick them, either along the back, on the roof, or on the back of the seat. Not sure yet.
Right, so my converters are stuck up. I've used a bit of number plate tape, which is here, that sort of stuff. Excuse the camera, it's kind of hard. I'm stuck in the boot here. So now the plan is to separate these, this loom coming down here, into two lots of four, and then the remote, because the four cables that need to be, that are going into the amp, need to go to the right and over to these to be taken down into speaker level. The other four obviously coming out the amp back to the stereo, so that's coming this side. So I need, they need to be split four here, four that side. It's harder in the boot because you can't see so much what you're doing. Whereas like when you're in the front, you can see the colours and you've got wiring diagrams. Whereas in the back here, you're relying on your bits of tape and a bit of paper trying to think about how to do it. But yeah, so I'm going to separate these, cut them to size so that I can then crimp these together. So that's the next plan, is get them, these wired up to the line converters. I'm going to use this one as the front, left and right, and then the rear, left and right. We've just riveted it in the end. It's gone further to the left, but that was the flattest part of the boot ceiling. Put a bit of number plate tape underneath just so it doesn't rattle against the boot. That's solid, it's not gone anywhere.
Now I've wired up the loom, half the cable's coming from the front to the line converters. Just using an 8 block connector block. Bit crude, it'll tidy up nicely. So for these ones I've just followed the instructions. So I've got one for front, one for front and one for rear. And it tells you on there which one left and right channel is, and I've just wired that up to the ones that are labelled. Just got a bit of paper here which tells me front right, front left, what number that is. And I've had the one with the red stripe on as the positive of the two. So now I've just got to wire the ones going to the return from the amp, find some RCA cables and then run the power. We're done.
Two channels wired in now, so there's the left front and the right front and the remote wired in. Now just the rear channels to wire in, which are here, and then I'm dealing with the power cable. Hey! Oh, the channel's now wired in. It's a bit crude looking, I'll tidy it up when I'm done. I've now got to work on the power, so I'm going to put some connections on that and get that wired up there first. So I've got the power leads in, they're all done, and I've got a crimp on there for inline fuse.
Right then, so my inline fuse is now fitted. That's a 60 amp. It's fairly straightforward. There's no point filming me putting it on because it all depends on the sort of amp, sort of inline fuse you get. Ideally I need to put a bigger fuse in there, but that's what I've been sent, and that just clips over like that, and I'm going to stick that to the case up there. Now all I've got to do is put an end on this ground, disconnect the battery, wire it up, find some RCA cables, and we're ready to test it. Hey! Right, so we're wired in now. Wired on the positive terminal there, and then on the ground terminal, grounding terminal there. Didn't have an RCA cable, so I had to sort of improvise. But it was all working. All working now. So. Just got to tidy it up now. I'm done.
All morning of pulling apart the car, trying to work out what was an issue because I lost the speaker in the door. Turns out one of the converters is faulty, but worked that out. Now taped up my loom I've built. It's the one that goes into behind there. So now I'm going to start getting the front end back together. Try and tidy up a little bit. Back in and fixed in. All the cables now run around the side down there. So now I've got to get the fascia back on and this bit of trim down here. And then I want to try and get this glove box back in. And then the underplate thing back in. Just got to take the cables up at the back before I do any of that. So my dash is all in. Cable's all taped up now. It's just a case of getting the glove box in. Fitting the bottom bit of trim. And then going to the boot, tape that up, dolly that up in there. Glove box is in. As is that little bit of trim down the side. Just got to get the base plate now for the glove box in. and then tidy up the front, work our way back.
Yeah. The bottom piece is all back in now. It is invisible, you don't know it's there. Car's all cleaned out now, looks so much better. Needs a good valet now though. Yeah, even in the back, you can't see it. The only place you can see it at the moment is in the boot. It needs sorting through now. Get something to eat, sort through that, tape it all up. Although I can't take any of the RCA cables up because I've got some replacements coming. And that converter there needs replacing because it's got a, you have to push on it to get a signal. I think it's got a dodgy connection somewhere in it. But yeah, got to stick that fuse onto that casing up there, tape the wires up, and then we're done.
All done, nearly. Boot all tidied out. And the battery cover back in. This is just my makeshift RCA cable until the new one comes in the post. Everywhere needs a good valet in this car now, but these all need taping up. But I don't really want to tape them up because that needs changing. So I'm not going to tape that section up. These are all going to get taped up here. Okay, obviously it's the RCA cable, but I've got to dismantle pull the glove box out because I know what the cable's rattling. The ISO male and female where they connect, it's just behind there. It's just rattling against there. Easy fix, just need to tape into something. But I wedged it so I hoped it wasn't going to rattle, but it needs pulling out and taping. Yeah, so I've taped everything up that can be taped up. That needs a little bit more on there. So I've got the power here, and then the speakers, and then they're going to the converters, but I'm going to stick that up there when I've got a new converter and my RCA cables have come, so then I can do a nice tidy job of it. I need to find something I can stick to the top to sort of clip these cables in a bit higher, just sit like there, so I don't sag, but yeah, happy with it.